Hi, my name is Nick with Load Cell Central, and today we will be taking a look at the SST1 load cell tester. The SST1 is about 5.5 inches tall and 3 inches wide. It is AA powered, making it a very portable unit. It can fit into something like a toolbox, tool bag, or a center console. The load cell connection is located at the top of the unit at this terminal block. The on-off switch is located at the bottom of the unit, and the menu navigation is very simple and user-friendly. Three buttons are used when performing tests with the SST1. The up arrow will increment values while the down arrow will decrement values. Once you have the correct value, the enter button will select and advance the menu. Now we will begin testing a load cell. For our test, we will be using our single point load cell called the ESP4. This is an interchange for many single point load cells and is used in low capacity scales. Load cell certificates show many of the tolerances tested by the SST1. The first prompt shown is the wires prompt. Load cells can be connected using 4 or 6 wire connections. The ESP4 is a 4-wire cell, but when 6 leads are available, they should be used. The next prompt is the millivolt per volt prompt. This prompt lets you specify the millivolt per volt of your load cell. This value can be found on load cell labels or certificates. The SST1 can test cells from 1 to 5 millivolts per volt, and the ESP4 we will be testing is a 2 millivolt per volt cell. This option will allow you to skip the load cell tests. Since we wish to show all of the tests, we will not be skipping them. The first test performed on the cell is output resistance. This is a resistance between the positive and negative signal leads, or in this case, the green and white wires. This resistance is usually listed on a load cell certificate and can indicate failing load cells. The next test is called input resistance. Similar to the output resistance, input resistance measures resistance between the positive and negative excitation leads, or in this case, the red and black wires. The positive and negative balance test shows us if the cell has been overloaded with a twisting force like an off-axis load. In an ideal situation where the load cell is loaded properly, the positive and negative sides of the bridge will deflect the same amount, resulting in very similar readings. We typically recommend that these two checks should fall within 1 ohm of one another. Anything above that generally shows the cell has been torqued. The insulation resistance tests the resistance between the load cell bridge and the shield wire of the load cell cable. This test shows us when the load cell has been compromised by something like water ingress or voltage surges. Cells that have failing insulation resistance often have drifting outputs. These problems can be caused by pressure washing cells that are not designed to withstand it or from voltage surges like lightning or welding. Most load cells specify an insulation resistance of more than 5,000 megohms. The SST1 is only capable of testing to 100 megohms, but will show the majority of insulation leaks. If the test returns over 100 megohms, the cell is likely okay. But if it returns a value lower than 100 megohms, further testing should be performed. The body resistance check is identical to the shield check, except that we are measuring resistance to the housing or body of the cell. The final test is called percentage of full scale. This test uses an excitation voltage and the millivolt per volt spec we gave earlier to determine what percentage of full scale is on the cell. Zero balances of 3% and higher at zero load generally indicate overloads. Zero balance test should be performed when the cell is uninstalled. This function is also useful in vessel weighing to ensure the load cells are being loaded evenly. This concludes the overview for the SST1. For more information, please visit our website or contact our sales team via phone or email.